Hey everybody, thank you so much for clicking on this video. So today we are talking about energy, specifically how your body uses it. Now throughout the video, I will be using the words energy and calories interchangeably simply because that's what calories are. They're a unit of energy within your body. Now, please keep in mind that if you have any current or previous issues with disordered eating, this might not be the best video for you to watch, simply because I do discuss things like weight loss and caloric deficits, but also know that I do not put morality on food, so hopefully this is still a very informative and freeing video for you to watch. So let's dive in. I've been wanting to make this video for a while because in the past year, we've all been using our energy very differently. Most of us are more sedentary than we were pre-COVID. Many of us are now working out from home instead of going to a gym or a group fitness class. We probably all have a lot more stress in our lives in the last year, and we might be choosing some less nutrient-dense food and more alcohol. Now, the question that I've gotten a lot from my group fitness clients is, doing a 30-minute workout enough? And the short answer is no. But not for the reason that you think. So if the only movement that you do in your day is a 30-minute workout, no, it's not enough. Now, do I want you to go do another 30-minute workout? No, I just want you to get up and move. Go do the dishes, go for a walk, play with your kids, walk the dog, put away the laundry. Literally just move your body. Here's the thing, workouts should not be thought of as a way to manually rip calories off of our body. They are a way to make you stronger for now and for the future. And then on the flip side, continuous movement throughout your day is not only a great way to help expend energy, but it's just a way to get your muscles and joints moving and literally help you feel better. So we are gonna jump into the science behind all of this, but first I wanna give you a real life example, me. All right, so I'm gonna put myself up on the front lines here and just show you exactly what happens to a body a year into quarantine. And I'm also gonna show you why. So let me preface this with the fact that I'm in a small body, and I know that. I'm very privileged to be in this body. But I, like many others, have had their body change in the last year. So we are gonna talk about that. Oh my gosh, okay, and one more disclaimer. This is not an open invitation for you to comment on my body, okay? Because that happens all the freaking time in the comments. People tell me that I'm bulky. People tell me that I don't have a butt. I don't need to hear it. So good lesson, don't talk about anyone's body but your own. Okay, now we're gonna go in. All right, so this is me about a year ago, pretty low body fat percentage, about 115 pounds if I had to guess. Honestly, I have not been super big on weighing myself in my adult life. And then this is me now. So you can see the difference in how toned I am. We're putting that in quotation marks, which toned, guys, it literally just means that your body fat percentage is low, so you can see muscle. So basically just my body fat percentage is a little bit higher a year into quarantine. So I'm still a thin person, but I definitely have about 10 extra pounds on me from before. So I guess I'm like 125. Again, still a small person. But now we're gonna break down my movement and you'll see exactly what the difference is here. So teaching pre-COVID, I was teaching 25 classes a week. Oh my God, I know. But keep in mind, many of them were at Form 50, which is the Megaformer studio that I used to work at. So we weren't on the machines doing the workout. We were just walking around coaching. How many was I actually doing the full workout of while I was teaching each week? And by full out, I mean like pretty much doing the whole class at 100%. I'd say like five. Four of them were dance cardio. And then if we kind of mishmash between like bar and core classes, that kind of equals another. Honestly, I was never really the instructor to like do the whole workout so I could get a workout. I was more of the demo and then go correct form and coach them type of coach. And then teaching now, I'm typically teaching about 8 classes a week. It does vary week to week. And I would say I do way more of the workout now than I did teaching in person. And that's just what happens when you teach virtually, right? Not everyone has their video on. Not everyone is in the frame of their video. So full out, I'd say about 5. Again, breaking that down, if we want to get really nitty gritty, it's about 2 dance cardio classes, a bar class, and then we'll kind of mishmash everything else together. So we can see it is about even. And before someone tells me, well, you were doing double the amount of cardio full out before, that's a whole different video, cardio versus strength. But yeah, that doesn't matter. So now let's get into my workouts pre-COVID. I was working out about 3 to 4 times a week, mostly at Form 50, so strength and conditioning. I would take like an occasional class somewhere else, but it was always strength-based. And then my workouts now, same thing, about 3 to 4 a week. Now they are all at home, but I am lucky enough to have tons of equipment and weights. They go up to like 90 pounds, and then I've got my kettlebell up to 40 pounds because they're all adjustable. So I'm truly set here and very thankful for it. Most of my workouts right now are filming for the Fit Club, but I do everything 100% full out, and like it's good programming. So, and then usually like once a week, I'm trying out a new YouTube workout for a review video, and I always do that full out to make sure I get the full experience. So typically, again, these are strength-based workouts, and we can see again, these are pretty much the same. So diving into my diet pre-COVID, honestly, I have never been consistent with my diet. So pre-COVID, I would like get on kicks where I eat more vegetables and nutrient-dense foods, and then I'd go and eat Pop-Tarts for a whole week. So I've just never been solid on my food. My diet now, pretty much the same thing happened for all of COVID, but since January, so right now it's March, and so for 2 months, I have been trying to get way more aware and consistent with my protein and veggie intake. And I finally feel like I have some sort of routine that I can keep consistent, like building strong habits to really just nourish myself properly. So that's a very recent change in the last 2 months. So if we zoom out and look at the whole big picture of a year, my diet's still pretty much the same. Just remember, guys, that like metabolic adaptations take a lot of time, and in 2 months you might see or feel a little bit of change, but that change is gonna take way longer. So last thing we're gonna touch on are daily steps. So my daily steps pre-COVID, I used to average 150,000 steps per week. That's about 20K per day. That is the beauty of being a fitness instructor in New York City. I was constantly moving. And then daily steps now, I average about 50K a week. So that is about 7,000 steps a day. And this is where we see the biggest change. So by using common sense and just looking at the two comparisons here, you can see very clearly why my body has changed. All right. Science time. This graphic right here, this is your total daily energy expenditure. My private clients and Fit Club members are probably like, oh my God, Justina, we've heard this so many times, but it's always good to know. This is basically just a breakdown of how your body uses energy during the day, or if we want to think of it in a different way, how your body burns calories every day. The biggest chunk you can see is your BMR. This is your basal metabolic rate, or in layman's terms, it's your metabolism. So this is about 60% of how your body expends energy during the day. So this is the biggest chunk, and typically a bigger body has a higher BMR because bigger bodies take more energy to fuel and move. And then a smaller body typically does have a lower BMR. The percentage pretty much stays the same, but just the amount of energy or calories that you burn by literally just being a human being does depend on the size of your body. Now, it also does depend on a few other factors as well. A big way that we can increase our BMR is through strength training, because the more muscle that your body has on it, the more energy you will expend or calories you will burn at rest. So that's why, especially if you do have a weight loss goal, making sure that you're incorporating strength training is way more important than cardio. Again, that's a big different video that I do have coming, talking about the difference between strength and cardio, but just know, prioritize strength training, guys. And then moving up, we can see TEF. This is our thermic effect of food. This is basically just how much energy your body uses to digest your food. I tell everyone, I'm like, don't even worry about this. It's not gonna change that much. It's 10%, it's such a small amount. There's other things that you can work on instead than this. And then we're gonna jump up to the top for our EAT, AKA our exercise activity thermogenesis. So this is your traditional workout. This is your Orange Theory workout. This is your Chloe Ting. This is your working out with me on the screen. This is anything that is like put on leggings and you're ready to lift up heavy things or get your heart rate up. And you can see this is only 10% of your daily energy expenditure. A lot of people overestimate just how many calories they're burning during their workouts. So I always tell people, stop factoring that in. Don't even think about it. Because the thing that we do have way more control over is our NEAT, our non-exercise activity thermogenesis. So this is any movement throughout your day that is not traditional exercise. So I gave you all those examples in the beginning. Go for a walk, walk your dog, play with your kids, do the dishes, put away your laundry. All of that is your NEAT. And you can see it is about 20% of your daily energy expenditure. So it is double the importance of your workout. If you do not move during your day, this huge chunk of energy has not been expended. And that is what has happened to me. So whether your goal is weight loss or if it's just to feel better long-term, taking advantage of your NEAT will get you closer to your goal. All right, so that was a fun thing. Honestly, I just wanted to break down this concept because... Are you kidding? Cool. All right, I guess this is my life now. So anyway, I wanted to talk about this because there's a lot of misinformation and just like convoluted messaging around energy expenditure and caloric burn, and this is driving me insane. So I gotta go. Hit that subscribe button so you don't miss any other science, and I will see you guys in the next one.